Super Bowl 60 in a few years' time. There's a look inside Levi's Stadium here in Santa Clara. Today, boy, what a matchup. Two NFL franchises with so much history, so much tradition, getting set to do battle here. As it'll be the New York Giants taking on the San Francisco 49ers. The Niners set to take over on offense. First play, and Purdy wants to throw it. Man open, that's Deebo Samuel. And they're able to get this one across the 35. Just like that, it's a gain of 12 and a first down on their first play.
That's a good start to the ball game. Maybe a little bit of a tone setter offensively. They come out throwing right away, and it's an early completion and a quick first down.
On first down, Purdy. He'll get this into the hands of Ayuk. And they bring him to the ground just shy of midfield. That's a 12-yard gain now on back-to-back plays.
Well, I think when they look at their offense, they think to themselves, weapons, weapons everywhere. And they want to move the ball around. They want to spread it to different people. But you absolutely know they want to get this man involved as well. And that's what they just did on that play.
What a pickup this man was last year. It's Christian McCaffrey. And he's going to get this past the 50 and into Giant territory. Brought down on the play by Kayvon Thibodeau.
And that's exactly what you want on a first down run. Pick up 5 yards, bring up second and five. The defensive line, though, they've got to figure out a way to out-leverage the guys up front because the offensive line is winning at the point of attack.
Throwing on second down, it's Purdy. And he will find his man, Samuel. And they're going to have another first down as the tackle's made at the Giants' 28. He goes for 18 there as the drive will continue. That early game script that they drew up is working pretty well here on this first drive. Already in field goal range, Charles knocking on the door of the red zone.
You know, Brandon, when we met with the coaching staff, they kind of predicted that they would come out firing like this. I think you and I were a little skeptical it'd be this easy, but they certainly knew what they were doing in scouting, in preparation, and understanding what their team was capable of.
A big-time gain there on the keeper, using his legs to hurt him. First down. I tell you, there is no antidote for speed, even at the quarterback position, as he keeps it himself and turns it into good yardage.
And it still takes time for a defender to react, even as quarterbacks carry the ball more and more in today's NFL. They're still a little bit in disbelief.
And he'll take this into the end zone for a San Francisco touchdown. Christian McCaffrey taking it in from 2 yards out. And the Niners put the Knights' first points on the board as they take the early lead.
Boy, we talk a lot about Christian McCaffrey and what he can do in the open field, and it's easy to gloss over how tough he can be to stop near the goal line. And he shows you just how tough he is on that carry as he takes it into the end zone.
Moody good with the extra point. And that makes the score 7-0. So here's Moody back out there now to send this one away. On the return, here's Gary Brightwell. And not much happening on the return as he'll get this to about the 23. And now out come the Giants. Jones and the Giants now with a first and 10 at their own 23. They'll try and start this drive in the air. That ball caught by Campbell. He's got this almost to the 40 before going out. That play going for 16 yards to start the drive, first down.
Defense gives up a touchdown on the opening drive. Offense, you got to want to get out there and get those points back right now.
And that's a sharp throw there to get this drive off to a good start. From up near the 40 now after the big play to start, here's another first and 10. Now the NFC's leading rusher a season ago. Here's Saquon Barkley. And he'll be brought down just shy of the 45. Fred Warner, the all-pro linebacker, there on the stop.
That was a really nice job by them picking up the run blitz and detecting it and blocking it and turning it into a nice run. And a lot of times you think if you blitz a running play, you're going to smother it. But a lot of the blitzers, they come in a little bit high. They don't have great leverage, and they're easily blocked and turned to the side.
And he'll get maybe a couple, if that, up to the 46. So they accept the penalty, of course, and push the offense backwards a bit. They'll come up now on a second and long after the hold. Off play action, Jones. That is incomplete.
My first thought is surprise, because that's one of the better tight ends around, and I've seen him pull in balls like this before. But how about a little credit to the defense forcing that incompletion?
An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. Back to throw, Jones. Now he steps away, and he gets this only to the 41, not near enough for the first. 5 yards, and that means they come up short, as they're going to have to punt here on the opening drive.
Nice call on defense, rolling out the nickel package for that big third down play, and they did an excellent job locking down coverage and forcing him to try and run for it, and he doesn't get there, which brings up a big fourth down call.
Now here's Gillen on now to punt as he gets this one away. And did they keep it in? They did. They kept it in. It's down close to the goal line at the 1 yard line. Amazing. Perfectly placed. If that ball goes one extra yard, maybe not even an extra yard, the starting point is the 20.
So there is a reason that a lot of punters are also excellent golfers. They know distance control. You know what else they have? Same groove motion over and over. Once they have that down, it repeats under pressure.
The drive begins with a run by McCaffrey. And nothing much materializing there on the first down run. He'll get a couple and that's it.
Well, he got what he could there, just trying to move forward and gain a little bit of yardage and create some space. You know the pressure is going to be tough defensively.
Second down and 8. They'll send the big tight end in motion right. After 1-7-0 on EA Sports. Here's a 2nd and 8. Near his goal line, here's Purdy hitting Samuel on the slant. And they're going to get this all the way out past the 20. That'll put him at an even 50 receiving yards now in this first half. And it's a first down.
So many times in my career I've heard coaches talk about completions are one thing. But as long as we're there at the catch and we get guys on the ground, we can live with that. But if you're going to give up 10, 12, 15 yards after the catch, then your defense is going to be in a lot of trouble.
Fighting through, and he's got space. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. Another big hitter there. This one good for 18.
How about that there? No frills, no additives, right? Nothing crazy. Just find a way to pick up the first down. A nice run right there.
On first down, this is McCaffrey. And he's going to get this past the 50 and into Giant territory. So that time they get the tight end on the hold.
Normally he's a pretty good run blocker, but this time he just didn't get his arms extended and let go quickly enough. The flag came out as a result.
Got it. Ready. Another run, this time McCaffrey. Big Leonard Williams there on the stop.
And this is why aggressive defensive coordinators love to blitz. It wreaks havoc because they end up taking their attention to the blitzers, freed up the D linemen to make the play.
Second and 16. They stay on the ground. McCaffrey again. And he'll push forward to the 37, gain of 2. When we talk about defenders, specifically linebackers, keeping their eyes in the right spot, he had that eye down the entire time.
And you know that's not easily done because they throw a lot of misdirection at you. They try and fool you and get your eyes in the wrong place. But you're right about that one. He correctly figured that one out and made a really nice play.
Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. It's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect.
How about this offense already feeling good about themselves with a touchdown already in their first drive? They've certainly come out firing, even though that one was incomplete.
With the 7-0 lead, more apt to take a shot like that downfield?
Hey, you're one to the good. Go ahead and try and press your advantage.
So on fourth down, here's the Australian native Mitch Wishnowsky to punt this one away.
You rarely call your punter a weapon, but he certainly was there. How about that? Pinning him down at the 1 yard line and helping out the defense in a big way. I'm telling you what, if I'm a defensive coordinator, I might be thinking safety right now.
They'll start out on the ground. It's Saquon Barkley. And after the nice stiff arm, the next wave swarms in quickly for the stop. Vanderbilt's own Oren Burks had the tackle defensively.
But both teams practiced this situation, and this time the guys on offense won and in a very nice way. What a run from that position on their own goal line.
Gave them some good breathing room.
I wonder now, do you still stack the line of scrimmage, or do you play normal defense? They may have backed them off with that run.
And he's going to go down right near the goal line. The officials look at each other. They're going to mark him at the 1 yard line. They'd like to avoid punting from their own end zone so they could use something here on third down. Up the middle with Barkley. And oh, he's just going to be short here, barely, maybe by a half a foot. It'll be fourth and inches. Here's Jamie Gillen now, as he'll punt it away for the second time. Forward. An 8 yard return there after a punt of 47. And the Niners will go on offense, first and 10.
And now this offense comes back out onto the field.
They'll begin with much more advantageous starting field position than they did on their last drive as they come up here first and 10. Purdy looking to throw. And this is incomplete. Very lucky to get that one back. That nearly picked. It's second down now.
I think he's got to be careful not to force anything into coverage right there. There weren't really any throwing lanes. But the best part for him, he's got second and third down to fall back on.
Now a second and 10. Purdy will set up to throw it here. This one into the hands of Kittle, the tight end. They get 6. That'll leave them with 3rd and 4.
Let's not quibble about the gain there on second down. That was a positive play because that was a take-what-you-can-get situation. Got out to the tight end. Now it gives them a much better opportunity to convert on third down.
Here is 3rd down and 4. Back to throw, Purdy. And he's got his man in stride, complete. And they'll get him down as he's inside the 40. They were looking to throw, holding on the big right tackle.
That's real simple, partner. Keep your hands inside in the chest area. You're probably okay. You get it out on the shoulders, get them wide. You're usually going to pick up a holding call.
So following the holding call, what can they do here on third and long? Throwing here, Purdy. Throwing quickly there, but it's incomplete.
How about some applause for the defense there? They forced him to throw that one into coverage, and just like that, they're staring at a fourth down. Well done.
Here's Mitch Wishnowsky now. And a little too much mustard on that one. It hits a couple yards into the end zone. A missed opportunity there maybe to pin them back. The Giants now going to take over late in this first half. And with just under a minute to go, they might try to think about mounting a drive here if they can and get in the end zone. Could potentially tie this game up. Now Jones throwing to start the drive. And that'll be off the mark, too far out in front, and it's incomplete.
I tell you, Brandon, this defense is playing with some confidence. Haven't allowed a point yet, flying to the football. I'm telling you, it's almost 11 to the ball on every snap. Another nice job there to force an incompletion.
After the incompletion, here's second and 10 from the 20. Throwing again, Jones. And that is knocked away in the middle of the field and incomplete.
I know we spent a lot of time talking about how the defensive backs read routes and make plays on the football. How about a good linebacker feeling the route, seeing the quarterback, jumps the play, and knocks it away? Really well done.
So back-to-back incompletions, and that has him staring at a third and 10. Barkley inside handoff. And they will stop him short. They get him to the ground at the 27. No first down. Now San Francisco going to call their second timeout as the clock stops here with 46 seconds remaining in the first half. On fourth down, here's Jamie Gillen on to punt. He's been a busy man here in this first half as he gets it away. Here's McLeod on the return, pushing his way through. A nice punt, but a good run back as well, 13 yards. And out will come the offense as they take over. Well, the Niners going back on offense now late in this first half. And with a 7-point lead, they'll likely look to take this to the locker room and not really press the issue. 35 seconds, all that remains in the first half as they come up on first down. Purdy, he'll get this out wide here to McCaffrey. Just a gain of a couple there, and it'll be second down.
The defense was ready for the back to leak out and even had a second player waiting to double him up. If you're going to commit to doubling a back, you better prevent a completion, but give him credit. Extra determination, extra effort, turn it into a successful play.
Now second and 8 at the 32-yard line. Now Purdy. And he will find his man on the end route. Complete. 13 yards there and a Niner first. So we've hit halftime here in Santa Clara with the 49ers out in front. As we'll send you eastward to Orlando, standing by with that EA Sports Halftime Report now is Jonathan Coachman. Take it away, Coach. And he'll be tackled just shy of the 25. The Giants offense set to begin this third quarter. Charles, it'll be interesting to see what adjustments this offense made in the locker room. Haven't really been able to get anything going offensively, virtually nothing in the ground attack either. So certainly something has to change here in quarter three.
And I'm pretty sure their friends from the defensive side of the ball told them exactly that, because those guys, the stop troops, they've been playing pretty well, and they've kept them around in this game. Now they've got some time. The running game struggled in the first half. Opposition knows how to focus on defending the pass here. They've got to re-energize that ground game and maybe open things up for a comeback here in this half.
From the 31, here's second and three. Operating from the gun, Jones. And down he goes. The 49ers get there. Javon Hargrave, the D-tackle, getting the sack.
So one quick, easy analysis about why they've struggled so far. They keep putting themselves in third and long situations. They just took another sack right there.
And the offensive film session tomorrow may be a little longer than it normally is.
Not a lot of positive grades will be handed out thus far.
Jones now on third down. And that is incomplete.
Well, he's smart enough to avoid the taunting rule, but I'll guarantee he quietly has told them, you might want to stop coming after me downfield, because I just broke up another pass and took away a big shot that you were trying to succeed with.
Here's Jamie Gillen now. He's been terrific so far. McLeod to return it. Nifty move. A nice return there of 11 to help mitigate a good punt. And they will take over first and 10. Here's a look at the 49ers offense as they make their way out for their first possession of the second half. Their defense has pitched the shutout. Now they probably need to deliver a little breathing room, maybe making a two-score game as they've got it first and 10. They'll start by running the option to the right. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. An ideal beginning of the drive there as they'll get 20 and a first down. Well, he is certainly dangerous when he spots a lane, and he keeps it himself there. Worked out well.
And how about the moving parts on a play like this? You know you have to practice it over and over, because it's almost like a ballet that has to be choreographed. But how about once he made the decision to go, he committed to it and went. Let's face it. Most teams are going to defend the running back much more than the quarterback on that type of a play.
A good run there on first down, and it'll leave them with a second and two.
Well, you certainly have to give a little credit here, because they're playing this game now at their pace. This is ball control football, sustained runs, taking their time, and making it work.
Now an option play on second down, and they will only muster a yard here to the 38.
I haven't met a defensive coordinator yet that thinks second and two is a fun situation to try and defend. Playbook is wide open for an offense, partner.
Nice job. Hold him to one after that 8-yard pickup on first down. This is third and one, very likely four down territory, even if they don't get it, though. They'll try and pick it up with McCaffrey. And he's going to have the first down yardage to the 35. A third down gain of 3 yards, and that'll be enough. In the first half, he was held in check on the ground, but despite that lack of production, they still have the lead.
Yeah, and they've got to feel fortunate about that. If they could actually get production from their lead horse, that would help open up this offense and widen this margin, too.
Now this time, they'll throw it. Here's Purdy. Throw right side is going to be caught by Samuel. He's going to go out of bounds, but he takes this one down just shy of the 20. 13 yards there and a Niner first.
It's taken a while for this offense to get going. A little creaky at the start, but they're oiled up now. A nice throw there, and they're really putting together a good drive.
Here's Purdy on first and 10. Back to Deebo Samuel for consecutive catches. And down inside the 15, shy of the 10. Back-to-back receptions for him, and it's another first down.
Well, that certainly has to feel good, and it's not all the time that the play caller should get all the credit. Sometimes I think in the huddle, the quarterback just says, hey, who's going to make a play for me? I just need something right here. And the end result there, nice first down. Drive keeps moving.
And a pickup of about four down inside the 10 to the 8-yard line.
Some of the most unselfish players on any football team, defensive tackles, because we ask them to just eat up blocks and allow other people to make tackles. But when he can make a play himself, as we just saw there, that's a big day.
Facing a second and six from the 8. Shotgun now with Purdy. A throw out wide, going to be incomplete.
And when you're in a one-score game in the second half, now's not the time to force the football into places where you shouldn't. And that's a smart decision to just get that one out of there.
And they'll be in search of 6 yards here on third down. This is now the 9th play of the drive. Looking to throw, Purdy. He's going to have the first down, and more than that, touchdown! Charlie Werner from 8 yards out. And the 49ers are able to extend their lead in the final seconds of this third quarter. Always important to get the first score of the second half. Now you start to pull away a little bit and get some breathing room going.
And now we find out about the fortitude of the group that's behind, because they were counting on getting into the game a little bit more, right? Maybe they get the first score. That doesn't happen. It looks almost insurmountable, but it's not. Let's see how hard they play the rest of the game.
So following the touchdown, here's Moody back out to send it away. This fielded right at the goal line. And able to get this across the 20, but not much further as he's dropped at the 23-yard line. Here's the Giant offense now making their way back out onto the field. They're staring at a 2-touchdown deficit, 14-0 the score as they regroup with 1st and 10. Throwing to start the drive, Jones. That one deep for Hodgins. Oh, a contested ball here, and it's going to be caught. We have played 3 quarters. We'll return with more after this break. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. So how about that for a chain mover? They're all the way down inside the 40 now for 1st and 10. Back to throw, Jones. Catch made here by Campbell. And he's going to get this inside the 30. Another good completion on the drive as the Giants have a 1st down.
Good yardage on the completion there. And when they look at the scoreboard, they do understand a field goal is not going to do them any good. My guess, they're going to press the ball downfield as far as possible, try and throw it into the end zone and get a score, because they know they've got to get that done and get the ball back as quickly as possible.
That one tipped, and it's incomplete. What good hands there defensively. It's 2nd down.
And not a common sight, at least on this drive. A momentary setback, though, for this passing game that has been moving well this series. Good thing for them, though. Still 2 more downs to connect and try and pick up another 1st down.
To throw once more on 2nd and 10. Jones, and that'll be incomplete. Took a pretty good shot as he tried to pull that one in. Couldn't hang on. 3rd down.
This has certainly been a physical game so far. Limited scoring opportunities for both sides. And there's another chance that goes unfulfilled.
This offense was on the move. Now 2 straight incompletions have them looking at 3rd and 10. Back to throw again. Into double coverage, and it's intercepted. Picked up by Charvarius Ward. And the Niners are going to take possession here. It's a touchback, and they'll take over at the 20-yard line. This one caught by Kittle. And they work this well upfield across the 45. A good pickup there, 26 yards. They have the nice cushion. They just want to pour it on right now, still throwing the football.
And I know my background says, why do you need to do this? Just go ahead and run out the clock and get a win. But as many people have pointed out to me, this is a video game, man. Go ahead and put the numbers up. Sportsmanship, not an issue.
Exercise those fingers. Now here's a throw that's complete. And they'll get him down as he's inside the 40. 16 more on that one and another first down. And looking to put this game on ice in the fourth quarter, but still not afraid to throw it as they show there.
You want to play the game with confidence, and they have a guy who's in control right now. Their trigger guy throwing it, they feel just as confident with him doing that as they would if they tried to run the ball and run the clock out.
And now a fake on the jet sweep, and instead they'll give it to McCaffrey. And he'll take this ahead for about four. Second down coming up. I'm sure that that's going to be the formula. Just keep the ball on the ground. Keep that clock moving.
And when you have the lead this late in the game, above all, stay in bounds. Yes, take care of the football. Yes, gain yardage, but stay in bounds and let that clock tick.
Second down and right back to McCaffrey. And he's going to get this pretty close to the first down marker at the Giants 30.
Brandon, I've got to think this offensive line has got some smiles on its faces. And I know it sounds crazy, but they practiced for this back in training camp. They knew they'd be in situations where it'd be extra defenders in the box coming after them, trying to keep them from locking down a game. Right now, they want to show the world they're up to the challenge.
They go play action here. Purdy able to find the open man. That's complete. And he's brought down, but not before he reaches the 8-yard line. A good chance now to put this game on ice. This is first and goal. And they'll try the option on first and goal. And he maneuvers his way down to the 3-yard line. Now the Giants will use the second of their three timeouts as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next. So the ball position now at the 3. Here's second and goal. Oh, how about this call down near the goal line? And this one will wind up with him losing yardage back to the 4-yard line. The Giants going to burn their third and final timeout as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next. A lot of tired bodies on that field, but this is a big play, third and goal. Purdy now to throw. And he'll just get rid of it.
I see the surprise in your face there, partner. That is a rare incompletion from him. He's been on point this entire game.
He has percentage completion-wise way up, not that time. So Purdy off and Moody on for the 49er field goal. This to make it a 3-score game late. And his kick is good. And that will extend their lead even further. So with that, you figure this game's pretty much out of reach at this point.
Yeah, it's going to take a heck of a comeback to come from 3 scores down. But don't change that channel. Don't go away. Miracles can happen. And you want to be here in case it does.
You're a company man.
Aren't I, though?
So after the made field goal by Moody, he's back out to kick this one away. And no effort to bring this one out. It's a touchback. And New York set to take the field. Well, I hate to say it, but at this point, I don't really know that they're playing to win with this deficit in the fourth quarter. They're just trying to erase that zero on the scoreboard, Charles, and get some type of momentum to carry into the film session tomorrow.
If you get any type of points on the board, it'll count as a moral victory, although no one will talk about that in the post-game press conference. That's not something you mentioned in the NFL. And this loss, it already stings and will for a while, but everyone on that offense knows it'll sting a lot worse if they don't put some points up on the board.
This to the sideline and over everybody, incomplete. No flags forthcoming, though. Maybe a break there. That looked like a clear throwaway to me. So following the incompletion, here's second and 10 from the 25. To throw again, Jones. That's complete. He's got Barkley out of the backfield. And not much to speak of. Call it a one-yard gain up to the 26. You got the big lead defensively. Willing to give him that underneath stuff, right?
And this is why you work on your tackling. Tackle them after the catch, inbounds, keep the clock running. Just go ahead and bleed the game out that way.
Now Jones. He's going to let it fly. That's going to be knocked away and incomplete.
Looks like they're going to keep throwing to the bitter end. This one's long since over, but give them credit. They're going to go down fighting. That one, incomplete.
No choice but to go. Here's fourth down now. Desperation time now. Here's Jones. And that is incomplete, but a penalty flag coming in. This could be a first down. And that penalty will move the ball to the one-yard line.
So difficult to cover a fade route, and you're talking about into the end zone, and sometimes you panic a little as a defender, and the offensive guys are really smart. Sometimes they jump back into you and create the contact.
A lack of discipline defensively on fourth down, and now that leads to a first and 10. Again, he'll drop to throw. And his throw is going to be incomplete. Well, the trials and tribulations of being a quarterback in this league, it's tough. It's got to be wearing on him out there.
Well, he has been sacked a number of times. He had an interception, so I'm going to give him a skosh of credit for hanging in there and trying to make something happen, despite the amount of pressure he's been under this entire game.
Second and 10. Throwing Jones. Campbell making the catch. And he'll go out of bounds after taking it a little further down inside the 40. That'll leave them with a third and 2 coming up. They got 8 yards there.
All that practice time came to fruition on that play. All those timing routes that they work on through training camp, OTAs, mini camp, and just regular season, they got it done on that one. An outcut, ball was delivered, and picked up the completion.
He lets this one fly toward the back of the end zone. And it's knocked away and incomplete.
Well, these guys are not going to go out with their tails between their legs. They're going to keep taking their shots until the clock's at triple zeros. But that one, like a lot of others, winds up incomplete.
The decision made for them. They've got to go. It's fourth down. They'll run with Barkley. And he's able to get the first before he's taken down at the 36. But no reason not to try it there, and they do indeed convert on fourth.
Fourth and 2 in the NFL, not ordinarily a running down anymore. Usually that ball is moved through the air. They went ahead and gave it to the back, and he ends up picking up the first down. I'm not sure if they fooled him as much as they just did a nice job executing.
Needed 2, and they got 3. And he'll get this underneath, dropping it off for Barkley. That'll go for a gain of 7, and that's going to bring up second down. So the victory here for San Francisco, and they did it in shutout fashion. Impressive.
Would it be too bland of a statement to say they didn't have the greatest day offensively?
Did enough, but yeah, you're right.
Most games, it wouldn't have been enough. So they've got to go into the locker room and applaud their defensive mates and say, guys, you really carried us today. We'll try and get you back next time. But as for today, you guys were nails out there.